talking about adjectives. Yes? Okay, next one, guys. Repeat. Hungry.
Syrian refugee Mohammed Talib and his 7-year-old son Obaida are learning English at this class for refugees in eastern Pennsylvania. Talib arrived in the United States 1.5 years ago with his wife and 4 children. They settled in Allentown, about 60 miles northwest of Philadelphia, and far from the violence at home.
It's such a rough thing to be in the middle of war and destruction and watch children dying in front of you. You just want to escape with your children. You're more afraid for your children than you are for yourself.
Allentown and surrounding Lehigh County are home to around 4,200 residents of Syrian descent, one of the largest Syrian communities in the nation. They began arriving more than a century ago working in silk and steel mills. About 100 are refugees from the current civil war.
It falls on us as local government.
Allentown Mayor Ed Pawlowski, a Democrat, says he's had to set up a new office to handle the flood of questions about the recent White House executive order on immigration.
I think that has sparked a lot of fear within the community, just not even in the Syrian community, but just in the community in general among immigrants, that what does this all mean and where is this going?
President Trump's executive order also worries Mohammed Talib. His sister and her family remain back in the Middle East.
I'm honestly very upset by it. People are trying to come over here to have a chance at a decent life, to live in a better country, to live well. He's depriving people of that chance, and I wish he'd reconsider and let people in again.
Talib is Muslim, as is his friend and fellow Syrian refugee, Abdul Qadir Al-Dalati. Al-Dalati says he thinks Trump has every right to protect his country, but even though the executive order doesn't mention specific religions, Al-Dalati feels Muslims have been singled out.
Before we came here, the first thing they taught us was that America doesn't tolerate racism whatsoever.
Now that you're here, you're seeing something different?
Definitely.
While Al-Dalati and Talib are Muslim, many of the Syrians in Allentown are Christian, and they're not all completely opposed to the executive order. Like Ayub Jarouj, he came to the U.S. in the 1960s and now runs the Syrian Arab American Charity Association, which helped Talib's family resettle in Allentown.
If the ban is temporary, and if it is to check to see who is coming here, check their background, I am for it. But to say no more refugees, no Muslim refugees, that's not fair. They love this country, they're doing a great job, and they are respected and loved by their neighbors.
Other Syrian Christians we met are more wary of those who want to come here.
We are not against bringing the refugees over here, but we are against bringing the wrong refugees over here.
Aziz Wahbi came to the U.S. in the 1990s, and Munsur Haddad immigrated in the 1960s. They strongly support the executive order.
So you see a difference between the people who are coming here now through a refugee program and people who immigrated here under circumstances like you did?
Yes, like the Syrian refugees who are coming from Jordan or from Turkey. We do not know their background, their relations while they were in Syria, because we have no intelligent information from the Syrian government, since we have no communication with the Syrian government. Are their family been recruited by ISIS? Do they have the radical mentality?
If anything happened, God forbid,
we're going to lose our good reputation.
And good standing, good standing. I mean, if we established a record in here since the 1800s. We established a good record to the Syrian community in here, especially in Lehigh Valley.
Both Wahbi and Haddad voted for President Trump. They say their greatest wish is for him to help end the war in Syria and improve relations with Syrian President Bashar al-Assad, whom they also support.
Helping the refugees really mainly is to help their country being stable again.
For refugee Mohammed Talib, waiting for the war to end was not an option. His family went through a year of interviews and investigation before the U.S. granted them visas.
In grammar, what are we talking about?
In Allentown, Talib says, they now have more opportunities. He works as a welder and his 4 kids are all in school. Obaida says his favorite subject is math.
Do you know what you want to be when you grow up?
A doctor.
It's my hope that the doors of immigration will open for refugees again, and I hope the American community won't frame things in terms of labels like Muslim or Christian or Jew, or any other religion for that matter.